This is my new show, Drawn In. I've always loved black and white, and I love drawing. I started these after a period of working with a ton of color, and I just wanted to see what happens if I just stripped away color. What would happen in terms of structure, the architecture of a drawing? I had had my work photographed, and the photographer would take a black and white Polaroid just to check the exposure at the beginning of the process. And looking at these black and white Polaroids, I was amazed at how coherent the work was, even without any color. At a certain point, I turned the projector onto a large piece of paper and projected a finished painting and then traced it very quickly with charcoal in an hour or so. Projecting a color painting and tracing it on paper in charcoal was the kind of activity I love in art making. As with other sources I start with, it quickly becomes tiresome to stick with the source. Once I turn off the projector, I have a way forward. To quote what Leonardo da Vinci famously said, "Look into the stains of walls, or the ashes of a fire, or clouds, you may find really marvelous ideas." These initial marks on the paper are the equivalent of stains that trigger associations and begin the process of making the drawing. In the middle of this intense drawing phase, I spent a week in a cabin at Feather River. I always bring art materials, and this time I brought charcoal and paper. I asked three women friends if they would pose nude. They were amenable, and that was the beginning of the Feather River series. At the end of 2020, beginning of 2021, I was in the tropics. I brought drawing supplies, in this case a new crow quill pen, something I hadn't used in at least 20 years. I've always loved pen and ink. The line is so definitive, so unequivocal. The medium itself is unforgiving. It doesn't reward speed and physical energy the way charcoal can. A pen can become very uncooperative, dropping blobs, running out of ink in mid-stroke, etc. I was delighted when I found this new pen so flowing. The large triptych is made with ink and a brush on a very fine material called portrait linen. It was an enticing mix between the experience of calligraphy and painting. Drawing is the beginning of everything. Because it's so direct, so non-technological, it's the clearest connection to thoughts, ideas, feelings.